A Basildon grandmother has blamed surgery delays for the return of her breast cancer. Michelle Hansford had to wait 3 years for what was considered elective surgery. And she says the government is playing God with people's lives.
In 2017, Basildon grandmother Michelle Hansford was diagnosed with aggressive breast cancer.
I had to have my whole left breast removed, as well as 17 lymph nodes.
She also underwent intensive chemotherapy and radiation before her surgeon ordered a full mastectomy to prevent the cancer coming back in the other breast. But with that considered elective surgery and Category 3 and 4 procedures delayed because of COVID, almost 3 years later, the cancer is now back.
Apart from being absolutely stressed and hurt for my family of them having to go through it again, I'm angry. Because I should never be in this situation.
If Michelle had received her surgery within the appropriate time frame, we would not be looking at such a debilitating path forward.
Michelle insists the procedure shouldn't be classed as elective and is furious at the state of the health system.
Mark McGowan's government has played God with people's lives.
Look, these are very stressful circumstances that she finds herself in, and I'm sorry for that.
After Michelle's latest cancer diagnosis, she's now been re-diagnosed as an urgent Category 1 patient and will undergo surgery here at Royal Perth Hospital within days.
There has been no change to Category 1 surgeries, so her surgery is now urgent, and we expect that once the hospital receives all of the necessary paperwork, that should be able to go ahead relatively quickly.
Health bureaucrats also forced to back down and let the children of terminally ill mum Jo Gittos visit after 10 News First spoke to her husband Darren last night.
And we're not going to be the only people, as I said, in this situation. So I think it's a little bit callous. It was thought out.
Today their kids have been granted 30 minutes to visit her in Bunbury Regional Hospital. There's still no word yet on whether Jo's mum can see her.
For us, every minute, every hour, every day is precious.
The Health Minister denies the rules are cruel and inhumane, but says a review is underway.
We've already had at least one incident where someone has contracted COVID in hospital from a visitor.
It comes as case numbers drop today. WA recorded another 2,137 new infections, taking active cases to almost 10,000. 21 people are in hospital, but none are in ICU, as our hospitals struggle to cope even without an influx. Natalie Forrest for 10 News First.